Recently, my good friend gifted me those two old RC cars. And they're pretty fun. You can zip them around and jump over obstacles. But I like to build stuff, and there isn't much more to do with these pre-built things. So I started to think. I have two cars. Together, they have 8 wheels. What else does have 8 wheels? That's right, modern armored personal carriers, or APCs for short, usually feature 4 pair of wheels, which makes them really mobile platforms with great traction, impressive speed and low ground pressure. There are many APC chassis around the world, but personally I really like our own Polish APC called Rosomak. This incredible piece of machinery weighs over 22 tons, but can still overtake you on a highway. Really cool! And so, the goal of today's video is to turn these two small cars into one fully functional 8x8 radio controlled APC. And bonus points if it manages to look like a scaled down version of the real Rosomak. Okay, so first let's take a look at what we are working with. Both of these cars feature a 4-wheel drive system powered by a brushed DC motor. These motors are quite weak, so I'm not going to use them. But what can and should be used are rear and front differentials. And by saying differentials, I mean this whole shock tower assembly with wheels, driveshafts, gearbox, suspension and steering links. It would take me some effort to design and print them myself, so we can save a lot of time by simply reusing them for this project. So, the first thing I did is I created simplified models of those differentials and aligned them according to the actual Rosomak blueprint. The whole design consists of 4 main component groups. Inner frame is a sub-assembly to which all the differentials will be attached to. It will also be mounting place for servo-powered steering system. Throughout the length of the whole chassis will run the main driveshaft with herringbone transmission gears. And to make it look like a real thing, I spent a lot of time designing this outer hull with additional turret on top. Some of the parts turned out to be pretty big, but luckily my Anycubic Chiron was right up for the task. All of the components are printed from PLA, and as always you can find them on my printables and Thingiverse profiles. Now if you are interested in making a similar project, you may wanna check out today's sponsor PCBWay. PCBWay is a company that specializes in making high quality PCBs in all shapes and sizes. For just $5 you can get up to 10 amazing PCBs and never look at that messy breadboard again. Moreover, PCBWay provides 3D printing services, so if you want to bring your design to life, but lack the equipment, you can order FDM, SLA or even vacuum casted parts. And if you need a component that can really take a beating, you can get CNC machined metal parts straight from their website. So don't wait and go check out PCBWay offer at PCBWay.com. Back to the video. To start the assembly, first I fixed all the differentials to the long bottom plate. Each pair is connected with a special herringbone gear. In the front, I managed to squeeze the double gear rack turning mechanism. Since the steering differentials are mounted opposite to each other, a contrary movement was needed to make them turn the same way. And that's exactly what this mechanism accomplishes. The only problem I had is a lack of space for servo placement, and so I decided to mount it higher on the top plate and couple it with a long shaft. But before adding this plate, we need to install the main drive shaft. It was just a matter of pushing 8mm carbon rod through 4 bearings and 3 gears placed in the right spots. Then I secured the gears with screws to prevent any slippage, and the inner frame was basically ready. To test the servo and later control the whole APC, I decided to use my simple 3-channel pistol transmitter. It offers less functions than typical drone radio, but will definitely be more fun to drive. Once we plug the servo to the receiver, we can see that it makes the wheels turn pretty well. Okay, so we have steering. Now we need an engine. To drive the Rosomak, I will use this 300 watts brushless drone motor. But once we power it, there is a problem. We can't control the spin direction. And that's because we are not using ESC made for cars, but for drones. Nothing a quick software update can't fix. To do this, we need to take an Arduino board and plug it to our ESC. Then it's just a matter of opening BLHeli up, flashing the Arduino, establishing USB connection and changing some EST settings. After the update, the ESC became bidirectional and it's much better adjusted for our car usage. Now we can attach herringbone gear to the shaft and fix the whole motor mount to the frame. By doing so, this one motor is able to spin all 8 wheels at the same time. Both the motor and drivetrain seem to work fine, although the gears are too loud for my liking. To fix this, I smeared some lubricant oil on all the teeth. I actually might have overdone this a bit, as on the first run, my workbench became one oily mess. But hey, at least the gears are quiet now. As you can see, the Rosamac chassis is eager to drive free. But before that, it needs a hull. So let's assemble it! Some of the parts printed with imperfections, so I had to carefully sandpaper each side. Once I was happy with the results, it was time for painting. After a day of drying, I was very pleased with how the hull turned out. But during the wait, I made some improvements to the chassis, like these stylish black rim covers, or front and rear LED lights. To install the white LEDs, I had to dismount the front of the frame and glue the lights in place. I then did the same with the two rear red LEDs. At this point, our Rosamac only needs some minor cable management and it's basically finished. So let's take it for a spin. It's honestly hard to describe how much fun I had with this project. Even though the Rosomag has high center of gravity, it feels very stable on the road and the traction is just superb. The only thing I feel could be improved is top speed. But that's a topic for another video. And here's a question for you guys. Which upgrades would you like to see next? Should I add a working turret with functional gun? Or maybe install Autopilot and send it on autonomous mission? Or better yet, make it amphibious and cross a lake just like the real thing? The comment section is yours. But for now, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like. And well, see you soon. Bye!